Hello and welcome to Zero to Hero, a beginner's guide to Loki. My name is Jay Clifford and I am a developer advocate here at Grafana Labs. Our ultimate goal for this series is to take you from zero to hero, learning the ropes of Loki, a log aggregation solution inspired by Prometheus. But before we get down to the nitty-gritty, let's answer the question, what are logs? It may seem trivial to some, but understanding the what, why, and how will provide the foundation for understanding Loki's architecture and feature set. Where did the term logs in computer science come from? Interestingly, the term predates computers and involves actual logs found in nature. The term log comes from the nautical term logbook, used to record distance, speed, and navigation at sea. This literally was done by throwing a log overboard to measure a ship's speed through the water. In computer science, we can imagine a log is like a diary for a computer. What you did, where you went, and did any strange events occur throughout the day becomes, what program or process did you start? Did you complete a task? Did you encounter any errors or bugs? As engineers, we care about these logs as they help us monitor the actions of our servers, applications, and systems. When things are going well, we keep an audit of their usual behavior. And when we encounter bugs or errors, we can use logs to investigate a potential root cause analysis of the issue. Let's take a look at three examples of logs: system logs, application logs, and security logs. System logs is an encompassing record that tracks the overall health and status of your computer. Examples here could be a record of software update cycles or a system error such as an OS crash or hardware malfunction. Application logs are produced by programs or agents running on your system. They keep track of records of their actions, such as application user events or crashes. And lastly, but not least, security logs. They keep track of events such as login attempts, password changes, and unauthorized access attempts. So how are these logs generated and where do they end up? How can we access these logs? As we now know, logs are generated from a variety of sources, such as our systems and applications. Let's take a look at how application logs are created. Imagine if we were building a massive online multiplayer game called Questworld. In Questworld, you roam around with other players, fighting monsters and completing quests. As the developer of Questworld, you are likely to begin orchestrating your code with print statements. This allows you to easily identify if your application is running through procedures successfully. As you start to productionize your code, these print messages will be replaced with a logging framework. A logging framework are packages which help you simplify the creation of logs for your application. There are many logging application frameworks out there, but the concept is universally the same. You create logging calls throughout your application code to capture events. This could be captured when a user logs into Questworld, when a user accepts a quest, or if a specific action has failed. A user has tried to complete a quest, but we failed to return the reward list to the user. In the next video, we'll discuss more specifics of what you can include within a log, such as the severity level. For now, it's good enough to know that when our application acts, it leaves a breadcrumb trail of these actions. So where do all these breadcrumbs go? In a lot of cases, these end up in a log file on disk. Each event is appended to the end of the log file. These files can normally be found with the .log file extension within your computer system. Let's take a look at an example of where you can find some common logs. We've created a sandbox instance of an Ubuntu server. You can find this in the description below. Let's open up the sandbox and locate some logs. A common place for logging files within a Linux system is within the logs directory, which is located within the vars directory. we can run the command ls /vars/logs to show us the list of files within the directory. Here you can see system and application log files. We will teach you how to open and understand these log files in the next video. You might be wondering at this point, if log files are stored on disk, why do you need a log aggregation solution for your logs? Logs, although incredibly useful, do present several challenges. The first is storage. Applications and systems can generate vast amounts of logs, which make long-range storage of these financially impractical. Imagine if your office produced one filing cabinet a day, and you needed to find a location to continuously store these cabinets without obstructing the space required by everyone else working in the office. Now times that by 10, 15, 100, and you're really getting to the scale of how much logs are stored a day. A secondary issue is analyzing these log files for useful root cause analysis. Imagine you were requested to find a specific office event within the filing cabinets. You have been told a few dates and when this event could have occurred, and you now need to search maybe 5-10 cabinets to find this specific event. Now imagine you've been asked to see if there was a pattern of this office event. As you can see, the manual investigation of logs is extremely difficult at scale. And lastly, locality. In a modern system architecture like Questworld, we would usually be building our solution using microservices. Lots of smaller applications, each with their specific role and task, all communicate with one another. These services can be spread over one to many servers using deployment platforms such as Kubernetes. This means we might have many different applications and servers all writing their logs in different locations. Each log might contain a clue to solving the issue, so we need to find a way of bringing these logs together. Finding a way to bring these logs together into a central location for analysis can help us build a bigger picture of events occurring within our solution. This is where logging aggregation solutions such as Loki come into play. And later in this series, we will learn about the features and services within Loki that tackle each of these issues. And that's a wrap for our first episode. In the next episode, we'll be delving a little deeper into the structure of logs, looking at log structure, format types, and why does log standardization matter? Until next time, I highly recommend checking out our Grafana for Beginners series, which you can also find in the description below. Also, make sure you join our Slack and Discourse community. Thanks for watching. My name is Jay Clifford. Stay curious.